Hi everyone. Perception is one of the cognitive processes and it is not always perfect, and there are errors in our perception, and one of the errors in perception is illusion. So in this experiment we want to demonstrate the extent of illusion with the help of this instrument, which is known as Muller-Layer illusion board. So here this board consists of two lines. One is a standard line which has arrowheads on both the sides, and the other line that is seen here is a variable line which has feather heads on both the sides, and the length of the arrow-headed line, that is the standard line, is constant. It cannot be changed, and the length of the variable line can be changed. It can be increased or it can be decreased. So in this experiment the line the experiment will be conducted in two series, the ascending series and the descending series. In the ascending series, the length of the variable line is slowly increased, and in the descending series the length of the variable line is slowly decreased, and the extent of error committed in both the series will be noted. Okay, so now let's move to the experiment. Please come. Okay, so see, this board is known as Muller-Layer illusion board. Can you see a line here in this end, which has arrows on both the sides, which is a standard line, and from here onwards, see, this line is a variable line. Now length of the variable line is definitely shorter than the length of the standard line. I will increase the length of the variable line slowly. You have to report me, you have to tell stop whenever the length of the variable line becomes equal to the length of the standard line. Just followed? Okay, so be ready, be accurate. Yes. Okay. Now, the length of the variable line is definitely larger than the standard line, isn't it? It is bigger. So now I am going to decrease the length of the variable line. So tell me to stop again when it becomes to the length of the standard line. Okay, fine. Okay, from this experiment theoretically we expect the subject is to underestimate the standard line both in the ascending series and in the descending series, and the underestimation will be more in the ascending series than in the descending series. That is, the error committed by the subject will be more in the ascending series than in the descending series. So you see here there is a graduated line on the back of the Muller-Layer illusion board. From this we can determine the extent of error committed by the subject. So she has committed a error of 60 millimeters in the ascending series and a error of 50 millimeters in the descending series, and she has underestimated the standard line both in the ascending series and in the descending series, and her error is more in the ascending series than in the descending series. Therefore, we can conclude that her result is in accordance to theoretical expectation.
So, thank you.